I'm going to go into my new empty Blackboard shell, and I can see that there are no available items in the course. My menu is empty, and I don't have a previously built course to copy into this one, so I'm going to start from scratch. And I'm going to start by building my main course menu. And if I hover over this plus sign in the top left, this cascading menu appears. And content area and tool link are the two items that I'll be using most frequently to build my course. I'll go first into content area. And I'm going to give it a name. I'll call it course homepage. Make it available to users and click submit. And the item has been created. It's just very difficult to see because it's almost the same color as the background behind it. Also, beside it is a gray box, which means that the item is empty, and whenever an item is empty in the main course menu, that item will not be visible to students at all. So I'm going to click on it in order to start building content inside of it. And I know that I want to organize my course content into two main course folders. So I'm going to hover over Build Content, and I'm going to go into the content folder item, which is going to allow me to create folders. So I'll click on that and give my first folder a name. I'll call it Course Notes and hit submit. And I can see that my first folder has been created, and I want to create a second folder. So back into Build Content and into Content Folder, and I'm going to call this one Getting Started and hit submit. And I just realized that I want Getting Started to appear before Course Notes, so I'm going to click and drag it up. I have now my two main course folders, and I'm going to go into the Getting Started area. And I could continue to build more folders inside of folders, but right now the course is as organized as I need it to be. So I'm going to go ahead and start adding content pages to it. And generally, content pages take the form of a blank page or a file. I'm going to start with a blank page, which allows me to build content from inside of Blackboard. So I'm going to call this first page blank page and drop content into it. And I can select some of the content and use the content editor to format the text. And I can italicize it and go into the color editor. If I don't like the preset palette, I can click on more colors and go anywhere within this spectrum and apply. And when I've finished creating this content page, I can click submit. And I see now that this page has been created inside of a folder called Getting Started, which is inside of a folder called Course Homepage. Also within this Getting Started folder, I want to add a file that I created externally. It's a file that I created in Microsoft Word. So I'm going to hover over Build Content, and instead of creating a blank page, I'm going to go find a file. So I'm going to select File, and I'll be prompted to browse. So I'm going to click Browse My Computer, and I'm going to look for a file that I created in Microsoft Word. I'll select it, click Open, give it a name, and click Submit. And I can see now that my Word file has been added to my Getting Started folder. This is the icon for an externally created file. This is the icon for a blank page or even an item page that has been created from inside of Blackboard. Generally, it is easier for students to access materials that have been created from within Blackboard as opposed to externally created materials which they may have to download before they can view it. Back out now into the course homepage, I can continue adding content pages and files to my content folders, but for now I'm going to go and add a tool to my main course menu. So hover over the plus sign again and select Tool Link. And if I hit this arrow, I can see that I have many tools to choose from. And for now, I'm going to choose Discussion Board and make it available to users. I'm going to call it Discussions and click Submit. Again, it's difficult to see. I'm going to click on it and add a first forum to it. I'll call this Week 1 Discussion. And I can enter my prompt, and I can format this text in the same way that I was able to format the blank page and click submit. And I can see here that my first forum has been created within the discussion board. So I have my content areas and I have a tool in my main course menu, and that's all I need for now.